Here's the study guide answers. I'm just going to work through this, and if you don't have the right answer, obviously fix it or maybe put a star next to it. And before you guys start the quiz tomorrow, I will answer questions. Okay, so it says for items 1 and 2, identify the domain and range. Determine if it is a function, circle yes or no. So for item 1, my domain, or remember all my x values, my range are the y values. So I have -3, -2, -1, 0 as my x values. And then all of my y values are 6. So I just have to put a single 6 there. If you wrote out 4 6s, I'm not going to count it wrong, but really you can save some time and just put 1 6. For problem 2, I've got -3, -1. Oh, excuse me. Is this a function? Yes. Because every input, no x's repeat, right? So every input has one output. For domain, I have -3, -1, 1, 3, and -3. So -3, -1, 1, and 3. I'm not going to put that extra -3. And then for my range, I have -5, -3, -1, 1, and 3. So you can see here that this x value -3 repeats, which means that the input has more than one output, so that's no, not a function. Down here, it says represent each relation using a different form below. So I have this as ordered pairs, so I have to figure out a way to write it differently. So it could be a table, you could make a graph if you want to. There's all different ways you can do that. I'm gonna show you how to make a graph if you wanted to, because it's super simple. Right? So I've got, oops, this isn't going to be the right way because I need to go into the negatives. I've got my x's and my y's. So I've got -1, -2, -3, -4, 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't know if you guys can hear through the microphone, but like the air conditioning just kicked on big time. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if I wanted to plot this, I would have -3, 6, -2, I think that's at 7, -2, 6, -1, 6, and 0, 6. So that's how I would plot those if I wanted to do that. Or remember, I could make a table. And then since this is a table for relation 2, so I just took these numbers up here and made a different way to show it. And then for a table, I could just do ordered pairs, in which case I would have -3, -5, -1, -3, 1, -1, 3, 1, and -3, 3. Right? So as long as you just do it in a different form, and I got these numbers from up here, made my ordered pairs, okay? Again, there's a lot of different ways you could do this. Just as long as you don't make ordered pairs here or make a table here, you'll be fine. Next page, we are identifying domain and range, right? So this is like what we did in our notes. So my x values have a definite start and stop, right? Because it's not going to continue forever. So my x values start at -5 and they end at 6. And because they're filled in, I know that it can include -5 and it can include 6, right? My y values have a low point of -4, and it does go up only to 4 because these don't continue forever. Right, so the x values is the horizontal options, the y values are the vertical options, right? So this is my x values, and then these are my y values, if that helps to see where they might happen. I'll make little squigglies. X values, y values, domain, range. Okay, so then for this one, we just have a horizontal line that continues forever, right? So my x values is all real numbers. Because any number is going to go on and on forever. And my y is a little bit different. Y equals 2. Because all of my y values, because it's a horizontal line, are going to be 2. Is this a function? Sure is. Passes the vertical line test. This one does as well. So vertical line test proved that. Don't forget that's an option when you're looking at graphs. Okay. Our next section is just where we do f of x, where we put the value into the equation. If we're trying to find the function of 3, I'm going to put 3 where x was. So I'm going to end up with negative 2 times 3 plus 9 divided by 3, which is like negative 6 plus 9 divided by 3, which is like 3 divided by 3, which equals 1. So that's my answer right there. If I was doing negative 6, I would have negative 2 times negative 6 plus 9 divided by 3. I'm going to have 12 plus 9 divided by 3. I end up with 21 divided by 3, which equals 7. And then over here, I'm finding the function of the number 1. And we have one of those tricky negative signs out here. Remember, that means that I'm going to square this and then take the opposite. So I'm going to have the opposite of 1 squared plus 5 times 1 minus 7. So I'm going to get negative 1 because 1 times 1 is 1. Plus 5 minus 7. 4 minus 7. Negative 3 is the answer. That's because I put 1 in for all those. Now I'm going to put negative 2 in. And again, this tells me that I'm going to do negative 2 squared and then take the opposite. So I'm going to get the opposite of negative 2 squared plus 5 times negative 2 minus 7. So negative 2 squared gives me a positive 4. But then again, I have to make it negative. So it's going to be negative 4 minus 10 minus 7. Negative 14 minus 7. And I get negative 21. Okay, so remember this is opposite of right here. Let's make ourselves a note. Opposite of. It does not count as the negative that's already in here. Okay, last page, word problems. Suppose g of a equals negative 2.5a plus 50 represents the amount remaining a on a gift card after purchasing G of A on a gift card after purchasing a number of apps, right? So if I was to rewrite this, I have y equals negative 2.50x plus 50, okay? X is the number of apps that you're purchasing, and 50 is how much you have on your gift card, right? That's our amount. Okay, determine a reasonable domain for this function. Well, the domain is all the x values, so I need to figure out what's a reasonable number of x values that I can have. Right? So if I multiply this times 20, I'm going to be done with my gift card. So the reasonable domain is x is less than or equal to 20. You can only buy 20 apps because 20 times 2.5 is going to give me 50, right? So that's the most I can have. So we could also put between 0, right? The domain could be during in between 0 and 20. It's going to be your domain. Okay? What does that domain represent? It represents the number of apps you could purchase. Determine a reasonable range for this function. Okay, so how much could it total cost? Well, I only have $50, right? So it's going to be between 0 and 50. It can't cost more than $50 because I only have $50 on my card. What does it represent? It represents the possible remaining balance. So right now it has $50. Every time you spend money, it's going to be minus 250, and so on. What if you bought 9 apps? So what is the cost of 9 apps? So I'm going to put 9 in for A. So I'm going to have G of 9 equals -2.50 times 9 plus 50. I'm going to have -2250 plus 50. So then if I'm buying 9 apps, I have $27.50 left. What does this mean in the context of the problem? Relate the notation G of 20 equals 20. Well, that means that after they bought 20 games, they have $0 left over, right? So if I was to put 20 up here, I know that I would end up with no money left, okay? So this means 20 apps were purchased. And there's no money left on the card. Suppose $45 was spent on the apps. How many apps were purchased? So let's say they spent 45, right? So I'm going to take that $45 and I'm going to divide by $2.50. So 45 divided by $2.50, because I want to figure out how many apps were they able to purchase. Move my decimal two places. 250 goes into 450 once. Bring down the zero. 250 goes into 2,000. 8 times. So I know that they purchased 18 apps. Now I know there are some people out there that were like, Mrs. Marsh, you just did way too much work. This tells me they only have $5 left, which means they could only purchase 2 more apps because they only have 50 to spend, and so you didn't have to do any math. You knew in your head it was 18, and that's fine. But if that's how you're gonna think about it and work through the problem, this goes out to you, Sebastian, you're going to need to write out what you did. Okay, so if that's the way you looked at it and that's how you figured it out, fantastic, but I need you to explain to me how you knew it was only 18, okay? All right, so that's the study guide. Maybe I'll have a cool little extra credit problem. I haven't decided yet. So please make sure you are ready for tomorrow's quiz. Thank you. See you guys tomorrow.